Ski performance breakthrough, priority number 5, control of speed and line. You will have become familiar with our 6 development drills by now, with the ski performance breakthrough priorities numbers 1 to 4. So far, you've been controlling your speed by using the shape of each curve to slow you down and by choosing to skid sometimes. The drills have helped you with this. So take a moment to appreciate the improvements you've made so far. Then let's move on to learn 2 strategies that are used by the best skiers on the planet. The first is the choice of exit line. This is a fantastic way to influence your speed and line. You can choose to change the shape of the last third of your curve, which is called the control phase, to give a variety of different endings to the curve. These different options are called exit lines. For example, wrapping the curve around tightly will really slow you down, while choosing a more direct and open exit line will allow you to carry more speed into the next curve. On the open mountain, you would choose the solution that fits your circumstances. But first, you need to develop these options so that they are available to you. Really wrap the last third of your curve around for maximum control for a couple of runs. Then, try a slightly more relaxed shape. And lastly, a slightly more open shape still. The bottom line is, whatever curve you are making, you normally have a choice of several exit lines. This allows you to finesse your control of speed and direction. So use our program of 6 drills to help you develop this ability and groove it into your performance. Please remember to begin on a simple blue run and use each drill a few times before progressing to the next. Give your body the opportunity it needs to change. The second strategy used by the best skiers on the planet to control their speed and line is choice of release point. Whatever curve radius you have chosen, whether you have chosen to skid or carve, and whatever exit line you have selected, you can add another layer of influence and control over your speed and line. Choose which release point you would like to use. This is the point at which you release your skis from the turn and begin the edge changing process. An early release point will allow you to carry more speed into the next curve, while a later release point will emphasize the control phase of your curve and slow you down more. Here's a great release point drill. Use your medium radius corridor to establish your rhythm. When you are feeling good, use a slightly earlier release point. The diagram shows you the effect this has over the line of your next curve. You may also carry a little more pace into the next curve, and so your release point may influence your speed, or cause you to make other adjustments so that your speed remains unaffected. Try several variations of release point to become familiar with the influence of this essential component in your whole performance. The bottom line is, varying your release point will become one of your major influences over speed and line. So use our program of 6 drills to help you develop this ability and groove it into your performance. Please remember to begin on a simple blue run and use each drill a few times before progressing to the next. Give your body the opportunity it needs to change. And there's more. Combining the choice of exit line with the choice of release point gives skiers very many more options for finessing control of speed and line. So try combining tight exit lines with late release points. This gives you maximum control, so it's great for couloirs and steep slopes. Try combining direct exit lines with early release points, this is very fast indeed, so it's great for racing, or for very shallow slopes, or for sticky snow. The limitless variations in between these extremes will give you the solutions you need to finesse your control of speed online in a wide variety of circumstances. This subject gives you three specific programs to work through our six drills: your choice of exit line, your choice of release point, and combinations of both. Before you ski each drill, please listen to the music that's been specially created to help you become relaxed and alert. This will really help you to learn more quickly and to ski more effectively. As you listen to the music, please smile. When you smile, your pineal gland releases serotonin, which makes you feel good and enhances the quality of your performance. By the time you've skied the drills, you will have developed the freedom of choice to finesse your control of speed and line, and you'll be ready for priority number 6.